It's Friday night here at Heart of America, and I have some winners for you in the Rising Star Latin event. This is Stefan and Agna. Congratulations, guys.
Thank you very much.
So you had a little bit of time from the time that you danced to the time that the awards were announced. Were you guys nervous about the results at all? Were you worried that how things were going to turn out?
Oh, very nervous.
So let you in on a little secret. Unfortunately, or maybe fortunately for us, they danced solo tonight. There was no other competition, but that was amazing because we got to focus our attention completely on you guys. Now, is it better to dance solo or have a full floor? What do you think?
It's fun to dance solo. It's our first time dancing,
and in the beginning we were a bit worried, you know, how it will go, because we are used to competitive dancing.
Yeah.
But then we took on public, which is amazing. Audience did great job, and it was like
great audience, by the way.
Yeah.
So it really felt like a solo show performance, which is so much fun.
Yes, we enjoy it a lot.
Yeah, it was pretty neat to have like a whole showcase dedicated to you guys. It was pretty cool to see all five dances just out there for everyone. Now, we were speaking a little bit off camera, and I said this is a pretty new partnership. Year and a half, did I catch that correctly?
That's correct.
Yeah, that's correct.
Wow, how'd you guys find each other?
It was pure destiny,
we could say.
Yeah, like we had so many signs matching for us to meet. A lot of things lined up, and... Yeah, basically,
it's like a sign, you know?
It was, yeah, a lot of signs matched, and we found each other. What, in like 3 days, we had a tryout, and we said, "This is it."
We fall in love from the first time we touched the hand. We knew that we're going to dance together. Yeah, and it next day we were like, "We are going to dance together." Then I took her to church.
Yeah, that's a true story.
So sweet.
<I'm> sorry.
Well, that is so sweet. Well, it was kind of fun sitting next to you because even. I see a lot of couples sitting together, you know, and you guys did not stop talking in a good way the entire time. I just felt this chemistry between the two of you. You just had so much, even though how much time do you guys spend together anyway. But even when we were sitting there tonight, it was just constantly back and forth. I was just feeling this natural vibe, you know, between the two of you. It's very
cool. We do have a
good
vibe.
This is our partnership thing, you know, what we have off the floor. We are super good friends, like really... have a big trust, have fun together, and I think that then comes, you know, then practices, competitions, and everything just becomes fun.
As well, we are like dancing for 1.5 years, and then I think we never fight. I think we never had any arguments, which is quite interesting.
We just get each other, and that really helps, you know, because as you say, being in this studio like 24/7 sometimes, you know, you have to feel the other person and you have to be comfortable with each other, which I think it's our really big asset in our partnership.
Yeah, and you use the word trust, and I think that is so important in dancing when it's two people out
on the
floor together.
That's the most important thing, I think, for any couple.
Yeah.
But this is the thing that we follow, and yeah.
Now, you mentioned your Globetrotters. Tell me a little bit about your international competitive careers.
So we're representing Lithuania, as I myself come from there. We reside in Houston, but we have this honor to represent my country. And we have a very kind of close event coming in Denmark. It will be European Championships in the end of September. So we will be preparing for that. Uh-huh. And then lined up is November, the World Championships in Blackpool, which we are super excited about.
That will be so fun.
Yeah, isn't that awesome?
Yeah. So, especially in Blackpool.
So, we kind of base our, you know, yearly plan on these big international competitions. Mm-hmm. And as well, we'll try to do as many local competitions as well because we find so much fun and such a good, you know, experience and stuff. Yeah.
What are some of the biggest differences between competing in Europe and competing here in the U.S.? What do you notice?
What I like about competitions here very much is that every single competition is like a celebration and like a ball. So this is really nice because the setting and the beautiful environment, sometimes European organizers, they maybe kind of do it more of a sports side.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Whereas here is very, you know, very...
More intimate.
Yeah.
I think it's...
On the other hand, European competitions gather way more competitors.
Certainly.
So we would experience dancing 5-6 rounds, and this is a different preparation.
This is a piece of cake.
You're right. Yeah, it is. But we try, even though it's a small competition or a big competition, we always try to do our best.
And we like, you know, we want to get like kind of different experience. That's why we want to expose ourselves both two international, like, huge events, and also two more boutique ones. So because it's different for us as competitors, it's a totally different experience, and we also have to prepare and adjust a little bit differently. So we feel that it gives us certain strengths, both of them.
Well, it is certainly paying off, and we wish you guys all the best of luck in your future competitions, and hope to see you back here right in Kansas City for the 2019 Heart of America.
Thank you so much.
We will be back.
We will be back for sure. Thank you.